Look, I got to tell you, earlier today, I literally had a moment where I was like, what is wrong with me?
Are you an inbound marketer looking for the inside scoop on what's next? Are you ready to unlock HubSpot's full potential and yours? If so, you've come to the right place. The Hubcast is your leading resource for user-friendly HubSpot tips, expert insights and strategies, exclusive interviews with inbound's brightest minds, and the latest insider news. And now, here's your host, George B. Thomas.
What's up, everybody? We are back with a quickness. It is me, I don't know, the man, the guy, just the normal dude, George B. Thomas, with the rock star, the one who likes to party hardy, Karina Duffy. How you doing today, Karina?
Wow, what an intro. I'm doing well. If I sound a little bit nasally, I've been a little bit under the weather, but I'm bouncing back. I'm feeling good.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I feel very blessed today because when we were at Impact HQ last week, which you might be wondering, why wasn't there an episode of the Hubcast last week? Well, we were learning how to be awesome, but several of the impactors came down with what would be only called as the sickness. And I was like, no, can't have any of that. And I got out unscathed. I'm good. By the way, this episode of the Hubcast is brought to you by Yip Yip, but we'll tell you a little bit more about that a little later. Karina, let's go ahead and get right into this HubSpot property of the week. This one's very interesting. You must have picked this one, not me, because mine have been boring compared to this.
Yeah, I went deep and wide for this one. This is a company property this week. It's called Web Technologies. Now, I learned something new this week because I didn't actually know this existed. But I was looking at company properties. I was checking out what's in there. What I learned also is that there's something, which I knew about this, but I dove into it this week, is the HubSpot Insights database. So if you look at different properties in HubSpot, next to them, if the little HubSpot cog is there, you'll see, if you hover over it, it'll say this is gathered or this property was filled from the HubSpot Insights database. And I'm going to link up an article in the show notes about exactly what the HubSpot Insights database is. But back to Web Technologies. So if you check out Web Technologies, it's really, they use, you know, they always use this in, they use the title in the definition, which you're really not supposed to do. But this is what HubSpot says. They say the web technologies used by the company or organization. Really what that means is, I think what they use is something similar to builtwith.com, if you've ever used that, which I was really excited to see this because I use builtwith all the time to see what CMS a website is built on, all the different analytics that they're using, but it's actually right in the company property. You can see it. So if HubSpot's able to find the URL of the company, then they can pull all of this data. And it's a little bit nebulous as to how they do it. They don't really say how they do it, but they're able to pull a bunch of these insights. And so like it'll tell you they're using Google Analytics, they're using a YouTube integration, they're using all of these different things, which may or may not, honestly, be useful to you and your business. I thought about this specifically for agencies. So if you're an agency that's specifically trying to target people that are using a specific platform like HubSpot or anything else, really, you can use this to target and nurture people to get a list of, here's all my contacts that are using Wistia or using, I don't know, Google Analytics, probably everybody. But that's really cool. So you can get a lot of valuable information on technology stack that your prospects are using. Could be really valuable too if you're like a B2B software that has to do with any of these platforms. So definitely something to take a peek at.
Yeah, Karina, I am like just sitting here. See, this is why I love the Hubcast. This is exactly why I wanted to do a property of the week. I probably should have released the reins a long time ago and just said, hey, go pick one. Because I'll be honest with you, I did not know that this was in there. And the fact that not only are we learning about web technologies, but we're learning about something called HubSpot Insights Database, and we're spreading the just good love on this ability inside of HubSpot is amazing. I agree with you, specific to agencies. I also think specific to any type of SaaS company. I want you to really let your mind wander, though, because you could literally segment off of like web technologies equals this thing or contains this thing. And so like if you're trying to sell against your competitors, and now all of a sudden you can see who in your portal is using your competitors. Uh-oh, game over. Whew, my goodness. We should just end the show right now. Like, that was enough value. Just kidding. Yeah. Just kidding, people. I would not do that to you. We want you to continue to listen. Hey, I'm curious. Out of all the Hubcast listeners and viewers, are you using Teams inside of HubSpot? Now, if you're sitting here listening to this or watching this and going, well, what is Teams? The answer to that is no, you're not. But if you say, hey, yes, we are, I would like for you to let at CG Duffy Designs and at George B. Thomas, which is me, and I just sort of talked about myself in the third person, which was kind of weird, but I was talking about my Twitter handle, so maybe not. Anyway, we want you to let us know if you're using Teams, because today's HubSpot wish list item is brought to us by Andy Hampshire, and his wish list item is grant users access to multiple teams. I have already run into scenarios where I wish this was possible around reporting and dashboards and all those good things. Anyway, we'll talk about reporting and dashboards a little bit later in the show. Hint, hint, hashtag strategy, maybe. Anyway, Andy says, we need the ability to grant users access to multiple teams so when they are creating deals, companies, or contacts, they can specify which team they are doing this for. This will allow for support staff to support multiple individuals in a way they can't at the moment. And in reality, in many businesses, an individual will often work with more than just their own team. Yeah, you think? Probably in every business, we are like working with multiple teams. Anyway, the user permission settings are for too basic at the moment. And, it's like for an individual. And we got to realize this is going to be for businesses and we need to be able to be on multiple teams. Anyway, not granular enough. If you agree, and if you're using Teams, and if not, you should probably check it out. But if you agree with Andy, then go to the show notes and vote. It's up. So, what's happening in the world of Impact Elite or Mastering HubSpot, Karina?
Impact Elite and Mastering HubSpot, there's all kinds of goodness going on in there. Didn't throw in a sneak peek today, but we'll be bringing that back as well. Really good stuff. One of the things, actually, you know what? I am going to give you a sneak peek because I just thought of this and it was that good. So Stefka Stevens, who runs Impact Elite now, just did an article on Cambridge Analytica and all of that controversy that came out around Facebook and Cambridge Analytica and all the crazy data that they're taking on people. And Steph wrote an article about that. But before she wrote the article, she sent out a survey in Impact Elite about basically just how people felt about it, if people were considering deleting their Facebook pages or Facebook accounts because of it, and sent it out to Elite. I don't know how many people filled it out, but there was a lot. And then she used all of that to put in the article. So there's a bunch of Elite members that actually got featured and were quoted in the article. So a lot of really cool stuff going on there, you know, not just people sharing information, but people actually contributing to content and different things. So really cool. We want you guys to join. We want you to be a part of our community. So head on over to Impact Elite and Mastering HubSpot today.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I love that you use this as an example because Stephanie and I actually had the opportunity to talk about this. And I said to her, you know, I think that just marketers should just stop using Facebook. They should just delete their account. marketers shouldn't use Facebook. And she looked at me kind of like, I don't understand why you would say that. And then I said, because I would be the only marketer on Facebook and it wouldn't be such a noisy place. Anyway, I don't think that strategy will work, but you should definitely check those places out. Plus, hey, you might be famous and be on an article on the Impact blog, which is always cool. You know what else is always cool, Karina, is this week's HubSpot strategy section. And, well, might I just say that I ate a little crow this week, because finally I broke down. I know Marcus and myself, we had preached it from the mountaintops, hashtag make it free. And, you know, Jory, which is, she's a HubSpot professor at the academy. She's amazing. And I wanted to do an interview with her, and we started to talk about the reports add-on. When do you know if you need it? You know, how do you know if you need it or you don't? Like, who's it a good fit for? We talked about all the different things that you could do with it. Like, we should actually just play part of that interview, which we will in a second. But I'm super curious, Karina, like, have you had an opportunity to play with the reports add-on? And are there things that you, like, love or frustrated? Or what are your thoughts on just that general tool?
I had the most opportunity to play around with it when it first came out, which I think was like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, longer.
It's been a hot minute. It's been a hot minute.
Was it 2015? Like it was a while ago.
Look, we've been fighting the good fight. Like yeah. We've used that hashtag for a long time. I'm just saying.
I know. And I'm like excited because like I listen to the Hubcast and you guys talk about it. I'm excited that I get to talk about it now. But, you know, I had the most opportunity to play around with it sort of when it first came out. And honestly, you know, I'm excited for the strategy session because I think I sometimes have a hard time understanding when people need it. Because you can do reporting in HubSpot without the reporting add-on. And there's other places that you can do reporting. And Impact actually, for our clients, uses a service called DataBox that we do a lot of like data visualization and reporting on, which is a big reason why I haven't done a lot of using the reporting add-on. But I think that, you know, maybe we should change the hashtag from like hashtag make it free to hashtag make it cheap or hashtag make it cheaper, because sometimes, and I hope that we'll hear a little bit of this from Jory, but, you know, I sometimes wonder, you know, is it worth it, right? Like, is it worth it in a lot of scenarios to pay the $200 a month? That's a lot, and you're going to need to get a lot of value out of that. And so, you know, I think it's going to be a really interesting session, and I'm excited to hear what Jory says.
Yeah, the interview was amazing. We do go very high level, very micro, very left, very right. Like, we talk about a lot of stuff. Let's go ahead and play a short segment of what is a larger interview where I actually ask Jory, so what are the, like, two or three things that people should do immediately when they start using the reports add-on?
I think the biggest thing is that there's such a big set of options available to you once you start the reporting on add-on, and sometimes you just like don't know where to start, and that can be really overwhelming. So my first tip would definitely be to take a look of what at the reports you already have in your reporting library, because they might not directly align with what you're trying to accomplish now, but it could also be a solid basis because then you can customize each of those reports. So take a look at what is kind of already there, because you might find A, that it's either already existing and that's a simple click add to dashboard, or it's a solid basis for how you can then customize a report. Because sometimes if you dive directly into the custom report builder, it can be really overwhelming, especially as you start to think about, okay, like, you know, I'm setting this up on the X axis and this on the Y axis, and then you have data visualization. You have a lot of stimulus thrown at you if you dive right in, versus if you look at, hey, like, this is the report, this is what it accomplishes, this is how it's built out. It can be a little bit more helpful to learn how the framework of the report builder works. The second one I would say is spend time in the custom report builder. You know, like, it's quite possible that you won't get it right the first time, and different people learn in different ways, but what I found with the report builder is the more comfortable and the more time you spend in it, the easier it's going to be long run to build these reports. So like, be willing to break reports and be willing to like have reports that don't make sense, because in the long run, when you're short on time and you just need those results, rather than kind of getting frustrated, you're like, hey, like I know why this isn't working, or I know like, hey, this is how I need to start thinking about building this report. So it can just save you time in the long run if you spend the time in the tool really customizing and seeing how those levers, if you will, change the data set. For a third one, if possible, to build your own dashboard, because I think part of this story of data is also understanding what you need and what questions you need to be asking. And sometimes what metrics align with you might not necessarily align with what your overall team or company's goals are. So I think starting to identify the areas that you in your everyday and those trends that you need to be watching in your everyday are can be really useful moving forward, because it starts to help frame what questions are helpful to you. And I think that can be so important and powerful moving forward, because you know, if you don't know what questions to ask or why you need that data, and then you just kind of look at a report builder and don't know what data you really need or how to ask that question, it can be difficult to get that kind of information.
All right. Was that cool or what? After that section of the interview, you should go watch the rest of the interview. Really start to understand if it's a good fit for you, if that $200 is a good spend. And look, I'm going to just kind of let the cat out of the bag a little bit, because on the larger part of the interview, we talked about how are you a list segmenting ninja? Are you using a lot of custom properties? Like, there's some other things that you really want to say yes, yes, yes to. And then you're like, well, crap, if I'm paying attention to conversational marketing and I have properties that are built in a conversational way, why am I not reporting on some of those anyway, that's enough. You got to go watch the rest of the interview. It's super dope. You know what else is super dope, Karina? And that is that I love giving free 15-minute assessments. You've heard it before. You're going to hear it again. Just go to the show notes, click the link, and go ahead and get your free 15 minutes. Like, look, you don't know what you don't know. And so let me help you know what you do know, or maybe you don't know. Anyway, we can figure that out on your free 15-minute assessment. Remember, in the beginning of the show, I told you this episode brought to you by Yip Yip, which, by the way, like, you can't say that name without getting exciting. It's like, Yip Yip. Like, yip, you know, yip. You feel like I feel like I should be at the club and like, Yip Yip, you know, like, and there's like bass playing. Anyway, integrated with HubSpot, Yip Yip is a true sales enablement solution. That's really what gets me excited, because anything that is a sales enablement solution, a tool for the sales team, a way to make more revenue, gets me excited. Anyway, reuse your existing content to amplify reach while helping the sales team stay top of mind with their social networks, which is always a little bit of a difficult thing to do. I don't know if it's because there's not. Anyway, never mind. It's just a little bit of a difficult thing to do. Be seen as thought leaders and generate net new leads for the entire sales team. Even though Jimmy's rocking it out, the entire sales team, one push of a button can personalize your existing content for the entire sales team and help them capture leads and build relationships in their own personally branded blog pages on your existing website. Wait, you guys need to really think about that. Seriously, like, instead of having just a company blog, it could be Jimmy's blog, it could be Sarah's blog, it could be Bobby's blog. And it's on your website. Anyway, go to goyipyip.com and find out more. Whew! My goodness. You know what's funny is if any Hubcast listeners are coming to Impact Live 18, like somehow, some way from the stage, I'm gonna do yip yip and see how many people like know what the heck that is all about.
Yeah, see if we can get them to do like a yip yip yuray. I think
see, this is why you are the co-hostess with the mostest. Karina, why don't we talk about HubSpot updates?
Let's do it. Let's dive in. So we got a couple here. We got some a new HubSpot Connect. We got some now live updates. The first one is visual refresh of the funnel report builder. So users of Sales Pro or the reporting add-on will now see a redesigned editor when they go to create funnel reports. Funnel reports are meant to show you how successful your team is at progressing deals and contacts through your buyer's lifecycle. With this information, you can understand where your team might encounter roadblocks and change your process accordingly. This visual refresh makes it more clear what the conversion rate means between each stage of the funnel, so you can see exactly how successful you are at each stage of your buyer's lifecycle. So for you guys using Sales Pro and reporting add-on, visual refresh, they're doing all kinds of visual refreshes these days. Really good, better visualization on the funnel reports there. Our next one is another visual refresh of content strategy. So content strategy, if you haven't heard, you know, HubSpot is a little bit, you know, excited about this whole content strategy, topic clusters thing. I don't know if we've talked about it before, but as search engines have developed to recognize intent, ensuring that you are writing in-depth content on a specific topic that is optimized for search is far more important than worrying about where you rank for an individual keyword. Can we stop for a second? That is a serious statement. That's real.
It got real up in here.
Yeah. This is where content strategy comes in. And the visual refresh of content strategy makes it easier to see exactly which pieces of content are linked together within a topic cluster. I took a peek at this. It looks super cool. Definitely a nice update. We've got links in the show notes to both of these HubSpot updates for the visual refreshes. So go in there and check them out.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, both of these are cool. You know, Karina, let me just pause. I know we got another update here that we want to talk about. But can I just want to engage the elephant in the room. And that is one of the things that I historically have loved is HubSpot's use of copy in very interesting ways. And might I just throw a bone out there? Might I just give a suggestion to whoever writes the copy for the updates? Have some fun. Enjoy your day, right? So like both of these, maybe it's because they both made the show on the same day, but now live, visual refresh of the XYZ tool, right? Like as I was reading these titles, I was like, this would be the perfect opportunity to delight, to just give somebody a part of their day. You know, like something like now live. Refreshed funnel report builder. So awesome, it makes you want to slap your mama, right? Or something just out of the blue where you're like, what just happened? Or, you know, now live, content strategy, visually refreshed, as hot as, and then I don't know, whoever you think is hot, just put that name right there, right? Which then that could be a debate, which they'd head over to community.hubspot and they'd debate if that person was hot or not. But at least it'd be fun for the day. Anyway, I digress. Yeah. Just have a little fun with your title. We're not optimizing for SEO. Well, maybe they are. I don't know. But in my, keywords are dead.
I don't think they care where they rank. So.
I mean, keywords are dead. No, we're not going to go there. We're not going to go there. This isn't a topic, is it? Just have fun with it. I'm just playing. Let's get back to your regularly scheduled program. Karina, HubSpot Connect. Our stack? What's this about?
Our stack. So our stack is a time management product that provides a visual solution for keeping your HubSpot tasks organized. Sales is a field full of moving pieces. That's true. With often many small steps necessary in order to close a deal. For the visually oriented sales rep, our stack makes it easy to stay organized and on target to meet monthly quotas. That means your sales team can spend less time digging through endless tasks and more time building meaningful relationships with leads and customers. Now, for me, not being on a sales team, hard for me to say how useful this would be, but I love the idea of it. We got a link to it in the show notes. So go and check out our stack if your sales team is having a hard time tracking some of those day-to-day little tasks that they're doing.
Yeah, it's super dope. They've got a video. Like when you hit the learn more, it'll take you to a page. There's a video you can watch. It's almost like Trello-ish a little bit, but it's super interesting. You know, today must be my day like for copy. Like, I'm like listening to this and it's like sales is a field full of moving pieces. And you kind of giggled at that. And I thought to myself, yeah, is it shrapnel or hand grenades or is it teddy bears and hearts? I don't know. Probably depends on your company. But I'll tell you what else to me is like teddy bears and hearts. And that is HubSpot masterclasses. Like, I don't know if all the Hubcast listeners are tuning in to the HubSpot masterclasses, but I'll tell you, back in the day when it was just normal old school webinars, I would join them. I would love them. I would learn a lot. But Jacqueline Payne in Tweets of the Week. Contextual conversation allows data collection easy, gradual, and organic. Obviously, Jacqueline was learning some stuff. In the show notes, we're going to put a link to where you can actually watch all of the HubSpot masterclasses. Look, you might be wondering, well, George, I don't even know what a HubSpot masterclass is. They are live virtual events featuring your favorite inbound professors, people like Jory, Chris LaDolce, Kyle Jepsen, we can't leave out. Isaac Moshe. Oh, Justin. Oh, I could keep on going. Anyway, your favorite professor, insert their name here, and their guest, industry experts. And you get to learn advanced techniques and topics that build on the framework you've learned in certification courses, which, by the way, you should be checking out those certifications. But if you want to treat masterclasses like Netflix, we got a link in the show notes, and you can go binge watch them today.
Yeah, I want to know if you guys went in. I want to know if you guys go and binge watch some masterclasses. Let us know.
Yo, if they do, they're as nerdy as I am, because that legitimately is something that I would do, but only when my wife is away for the week, because then I have extra time. All right, questions of the week.
Yeah, so I want to know, we're gonna sit on the topic of self-education here, and speaking of master classes and certification courses, we want to know, how many certifications do you currently have?
Yeah.
And what is your roadmap, or do you have one, to get all of them? So I will say, I have 9 certifications.
Yeah.
Which used to be a lot.
Yeah.
At one point I had all of the certifications that existed.
Yeah.
And then they just keep coming out with more, and I'm still catching up. But George, you have a few, don't you?
You know, here's the thing. Like, this is why it's the question of the week, because, like, as we record this, I have watched the last set of videos for the last certification that I need to get, and I'm going to take the test tonight. Once the kiddos go to bed, I'm just sit down, take the test, and that will mean, for the first time ever, I will have 18 out of 18 possible certifications.
Oh my goodness.
Now, for some of you, you're like, where are the other ones hidden? There are some that you can get when you are part of an agency that you can't get as just a normal HubSpot user. But the question truly is, are you on a road to mastery? Meaning, this thing that is inbound, this thing that is HubSpot, inbound sales, inbound, you know, service, eventually inbound video, inbound conversational marketing. Are you in the mindset of becoming a master at what you do? I'm super curious to just how many certifications people have. I really, really, Karina, to be honest with you, this is kind of selfish because I want to know, like, who were the other hashtag nerds? Who were the other people out on this planet, this big planet with like billies of people that have 18 HubSpot certifications? I really want to know. Like, I feel like we should have some type of funded family reunion at some point and just talk about HubSpot in all its glory.
Mm-hmm.
No, we really shouldn't. Actually, I would just cook.
I don't know, George. You might be the only one. I don't know.
Nah, it can't be true. It can't
be true.
They just
keep coming out. They just keep coming out with new ones. It's hard to keep up.
It is hard to keep up. I want to know if anybody else is out there that has them all. I want to know, what's your roadmap? Karina wants to know too. Please let us know. You know our Twitters, but also if it's something that you don't want to tweet out and you want to have a conversation about it, it's gthomas@impactbnd. That's BobbyNancyDrew.com, which is totally not names that you should use for any type of, like, anyway. The people that have been in the military that just heard me do that are ready to come through the airwaves and punch me in my face. Till next time, folks, this has been Karina Duffy and George B. Thomas. Hey, if you're listening on your favorite iTunes, Apple. No, I'm just kidding. If you're listening on your... Which, never mind. If you're listening to this podcast, make sure you go over, leave us a rating and review. If you're watching, it's been an interesting one, that's for sure. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, the Mastering HubSpot YouTube channel. Until next time, this is Karina Duffy and George B. Thomas saying to you, go out into the world and do some...
Happy HubSpotting.
I love throwing her on the spot like that. Have a good day.